Okay, chillax everyone. It's just me just talking because talking is nice and fun and it's like camera, like comment section, put the two together, maybe some kind of either like really deep thinking or a moment of like, you know, those quizzical, things which go on inside your head and makes you think like, maybe you'll get some of that going on. I don't know, it's up to you how you react to this. But there's this one lovely long comment, because like what with the modern day comment section, people can't just troll you in like a tweet, apart from on Twitter, when that's what you do, right? But here we got this wonderful, like half an A4 side of text going down here about the Ouija board. It starts off with a bit of history, saying the modern Ouija board was created in the late 1800s as interest in spiritualism grew. A Ouija board is simply a game board that has the alphabet, numerals, and yes, no printed on its face. Right, fine, okay, that's great. It then says they are often considered to be communication gateways to those who have passed over. Of course, this is based upon superstition that spirits or ghosts even exist in the first place and that they can or want to communicate with the world of the living. Interesting, okay, because there's the use of the word superstition there. Then, you got this opening paragraph, which is relatively objective and rational. Then it says the Bible has a few things to say about engaging activities of this nature. So, like, the word superstition appears there, presumably to suggest skeptical rational thoughts, and then you've got like completely lack of skeptical rational thought applied to the Bible. And we got quotes from Leviticus, Deuteronomy, Isaiah, Galatians. And then there's this really weird addition here. It says occultists will insist that the boards work by allowing spirits of the dead to move the pointer in answer to queries. I don't. But here it's telling me I do. Occultists will insist. And then it says scientists have yet to prove that the pointer is moved by anything other than the living people touching the pointer. So that looks like a rather skeptical approach. So essentially, you've got one sentence which then disses the occultists, the other sentence bigs up the scientists, and then further on down. It says, no matter how innocent it may seem, playing with Ouija boards can be an opening for demons to invade our hearts and minds. All demonic activity is under the control of Satan, whom Peter described in no uncertain terms. Your enemy, the devil, prowls around you like a roaring lion looking for someone to devour. 2 Peter 5, verse 8. The scriptural example of dealing with items that pertain to occult books, music, jewelry, occult games, and other occult objects is to confess involvement with them as a sin and burn the items safely, of course, according to Acts 19, 18, and 19. Of course, I've added a bit of like dramatic acting and behavior in order to deliver this in a way which might help to emphasize a few points in the text which is being given to me. But I don't think it is just me that can see that there's this like conflict of ideas going on in this person's head. You're all superstitious, but you're inviting demons into your heart. The scientists don't think it's anything apart from your fingers, which is moving the pointer. But there's demons coming into your heart. It's just superstition. But the Bible says this. Ha ha. Thinking? Did you miss out on that day at school, that class, that year, decade, millennium. It just boggles me that someone can express so many different perspectives to try and like entice you into reading more, and then to terrify you with interpretations of religion, which is just there to make you afraid. You know, it's being used to make you afraid. And if you're going to use like a phrase from the Bible, I understand that the one phrase which is used most in the Bible is "do not be afraid." In the whole Bible, Old and New Testament, the one phrase which is repeated more than any others is "do not be afraid." I think that's the case. I haven't actually done the search on Bible Gateway to prove it, but you know, if it says it once, then essentially, why would a human being want to be such a jerk as to just fuck with people in this way? I mean, what is? I mean, this is why, like, you know, interpretive theology is so much more important, because it gives you room to think, because you. The ability to assess and to analyze and to be critical. And I don't agree with what he says occultists are, because like you can create titles for yourself and for somebody else, okay? Alright, and when you do that, you're creating politics the moment you do that, okay? And if you have rigid definitions of what you are and rigid definitions to what they are, okay? Just imagine your head is over here, okay? Your head is here, okay? And you take, like, your rigid definitions of what you are and place them there. And the rigid definitions of what somebody else is and you place them there. And you cook the whole lot up, okay? Not your head, but the whole lot over here up with your heart being invested into this. Your sense of identity being invested into this, okay? Your sense of loyalty being invested into this. Your sense of superiority or your cultural whatever as being like, you know, really, really vital, okay? You cook all these things up together. And the moment your timer goes off, when all the cooking is done, it's like your arse appears here and your head rams straight into it. And you become so full of yourself, you become entering into like dogmatic circular reasoning. And you can't think a way out of it. And I think that we as humans go through phases like that. And I had a phase like that a while ago when I was creating separation between myself and other groups and stuff. And they did the same against me. But relax. Because like at any one moment in time, there's not one Christian, and there's not one Christianity, there's another Christianity for every single individual in the world, okay? There's not one Wicca, but there's Wiccas for every single person in the world, and all of them will be changing with time, thus changing the number of Wiccas that there are in the world, or the number of Christianities that there are in the world. And the same with like all the rest of the faiths, and also the modern day atheist cults with all their beliefs, and which it is, you know, it just is. Relax, okay? I'm just trying to remove these definitions, remove these sort of like cultural overlays, and just like be a little bit more human, you know? Because if we can do that, I think we'll reach a time when we'll actually be more evolved than my cat. Which I don't think we are as a species yet. I just don't. Not yet. But I believe we'll get there. Peace.